C# 10 brings a bunch of new features. And in addition, we're doing something new with it. There'll be a preview of a new feature in the release of C# 10. So what's happening is there's some features that are so big, they don't fit in our current 1-year cycle. We can get them done, but we can't get feedback on them and make sure they're right. So the new feature, the big new feature, is going to be some static interface work that is going to allow us to do, the big thing is numeric math. And so there'll be some great new things that will come from this, but that part is in preview in C# 10. The rest of C# 10 is stable and ready to go. See a bunch of things. Struct's got some love. You'll see parameterless constructors and field initializers. And also you can now make record structs. So namespaces appear at the top of so many of your files, followed by the curly bracket, and then there's a curly bracket at the bottom. Now you can do what's called a file scoped namespace. And what that means is you can leave out those two curly brackets and have one less set of indentation. Another thing is coming is global usings. You know those usings that are at the top of every file? You can put them in into your project one time, and they'll be valid across all of your project. There's also some just general improvements. Interpolated strings have some improvements, along with lambdas and some other things there. There's also a V2 of source generators. So you may not have written a source generator yourself, but source generators are driving a lot of fantastic changes that are going on in the ecosystem and that you get to take advantage of. Another little feature we've got is called caller argument expression. So in addition to getting the name of an argument, you can also get the expression that was passed. So check out C# 10. It's a fantastic release. I think you'll really enjoy playing with it.